Welcome to PyMOL 101 with Molecular Memory. In this lesson, we'll explore the less active conformation of phosphofructokinase bound to an inhibitor. We'll use the inhibitor to generate a binding site instead of selecting residues given to us in a manuscript, like we did in Lesson 2. This is helpful when we may not have access to an article. Load the biological assembly of 6-PFK in PyMOL. File, get PDB, 6-PFK, assembly 1. Then color by chain with CPK coloring and display the sequence. Scroll until you see the three-letter codes for the inhibitor molecules. Notice the PGA ligands have taken on the color of a chain that they're close to. We'll model the interactions of just one of the ligands. Let's select the cyan PGA, this light blue-green one here. The letters SELE pop up. In Lesson 2, we learned to rename selections to save them. A, rename. Delete the letters SELE that come up in the upper left of the structure viewer window. Type inhibitor and press enter. Now I'll click in the blank space to make sure I don't add anything unwanted to this selection. Let's zoom in on the inhibitor. A, zoom. I'll use the pinch motion on my trackpad to zoom out a bit. If you're using a mouse, right-click will zoom. There's too much clipping to really see the binding site, so I'll adjust that by running two fingers up and down on the trackpad. Now we can see the inhibitor is actually binding between two chains of the protein. If we want to focus on just the parts of the structure the ligand is interacting with, we can hide the other chains. This isn't 100% necessary here, but I really want to show you some of the options in the mouse control menu. Click where it says selecting residues, and the menu changes. Let's stop on chains. Click on the inhibitor and the two chains in the structure viewer. You can also select by clicking in the sequence display menu. Zoom out a bit, and then next to SELE, hide unselected. Now we're going to copy the inhibitor selection and modify it. Inhibitor, A, duplicate. A new selection, SELO1, pops up. We'll turn this into the binding site. So let's rename it binding. To select nearby residues, A, modify, around, residues within 4 angstroms to capture all hydrogen bonding amino acids. If you choose a 5 angstrom sphere, that'll capture residues that may be interacting through van der Waals interactions too. Now show sticks and zoom in on the binding site. To select binding site water molecules only, we can modify the binding site selection we just made. Duplicate the selection called binding. Rename SELO2 to active water. Now, action button, modify, restrict to solvent. And let's show these as spheres. Time for some adjustments. The water spheres are large and obscuring the active site. Resize them using a preset. A, preset, ball and stick. The inhibitor's cyan carbons are blending in with some of the binding site residues. Let's recolor them. C, by element, and I'll select this one with white carbons. Now to add some interactions. Inhibitor, A button, find, polar contacts. There are a bunch of choices here, but let's just choose 2N atoms. And we can indeed see interactions with both protein chains. If we'd like, we can change the line color. Let's try magenta. And as we're getting closer to a publication quality image, let's go ahead and change the background to white. Display dropdown, background, white. If we want to remove the nearby residues that aren't making polar contacts, we can, even though they're close enough to have van der Waals interactions with the ligand. First, we need to change our mouse control menu back to the default Residues. Click here in the mouse control menu until it reads Residues. Now click on Binding in the Names panel. Carefully deselect any residues that don't have dotted lines going to them by clicking on them. You'll need to rotate and zoom while doing this. And if you accidentally deselect something you didn't mean to, just click on it again to add it back. Okay, I think everything still selected has polar interactions now. The best way to show our modified binding site is to hide all the sticks, then add back the inhibitor and modified active site. First, 6PFK, hide sticks. Now let's add the hydrogen bonding residues back. Inhibitor, show sticks. Binding, show sticks. Finally, click in the blank space to deselect everything. Notice this arginine is interacting through its side chain, but we're showing the entire residue with its backbone atoms. We can clean this up a bit more by just showing the side chain. And we can do this one or two residues at a time without saving the selection. Click on the appropriate residues. SELE, hide main chain. Looking good. We can delete this selection if we want now. We want someone looking at our image to be able to easily interpret it. Let's label the amino acid residues of the binding site. Binding L residues. Okay, there they are, but some are super hard to see. We're gonna move them using edit mode. To start, I remove all clipping and find a relatively unobscured view of the binding site where all of the residues can be seen clearly. Now zoom the binding site to let PyMOL add its own clipping back. Now, you need to save your session. This is an essential save point. You can completely mess up the protein in edit mode, and you can't undo it. So take a moment to save your PyMOL PSE session file. Control save. In the mouse control menu, the mouse mode can be changed from viewing to an editing mode by clicking. Now, if I press Command on my Mac keyboard and click and drag on the labels, I can reposition them. But if you accidentally click the protein, you can move it, completely messing up the structure. So I encourage you to save after each and every label move. Awesome job, that's a ton of work. First, click on the mouse control menu to exit edit mode. Now save a scene of your hard work. In the drop-down menus, Scene, Store, F1. Right-click on the scene and rename it. It's really tricky to show an active site without a protein loop getting in the way or some poor-looking clipping. To be honest, I sometimes completely hide the amino acid residues in a loop that's getting in the way. I really like the context the cartoon gives, but another strategy is to hide the cartoon completely. 6PFK, H, cartoon. Now we can remove clipping completely, and the active site residues just seem to float there. Let's save a scene. Now you can toggle back and forth and choose which scene you prefer, or try to modify further. Thanks for watching this episode of PyMOL 101. Next time, we'll learn about the measurement wizard. If you're enjoying this series, please subscribe to my channel.